Attention, home buyers. This video's for you because when you write an offer in a seller's market, you don't get a second chance to make a good first impression. Stay tuned and we'll help you out. Welcome to Step Into the Valley with Katrina Du at the 3-Step Realty Group. In today's episode, we're going to be talking to you home buyers out there in the real estate market who are competing with other buyers because you don't get a second chance to make a good first impression with the seller. So what we're going to do is go over some things that you can do in your offer to make that good first impression, especially when you're competing with 2, 5, 10 other buyers who want that home that you're in love with. How do you make a good first impression on your offer to the seller? Well, it all comes down to how much risk for the seller can you remove from your offer? And of course, how much money do you put in? And that goes to the terms of the offer. Let's dig in and talk about the first one, the biggest one, price. How much money are you willing to pay for that home? So let's say you're looking at a home that's $500,000. That's what it's listed for, and you know you're competing with 5, 10 other buyers who love your future house. So how much do you offer? How much are you willing to offer for the home? Maybe you're willing to pay $530,000 for the home, but let's face it, you don't wanna pay $530,000 for the home if you don't have to. So there is a strategy called an escalation clause that you could possibly use if you chose to. And what that means is you write an offer for $510,000 for the home, stating that you're willing to pay a certain dollar amount, $1,000, over the highest offer that comes in for that home, not to exceed $530,000. So that means you're willing to pay that much if it came to it because you want to secure that home as yours. That's the escalation clause. It's a possible strategy to use. Another way to put your best foot forward in the offer to the sellers is the time frames that you write in your offer. Shorten them as much as possible, meaning the number of days it takes to close on that home, as short as you can possibly make it, shorten it. Talk to your lender, talk to your escrow company, talk to your agent. How short can we make this? Now, you also have some other time frames in there, such as appraisal, inspections, and your final loan approval. How short can you make those contingencies in there? Because the shorter they are, the less risk for the seller, which makes you look better to them. How can you get them as short as possible? Well, I'm gonna give you a hint. Go to your lender, if you're getting a loan, and ask them before you even go out looking, can you send me to an underwriter and get me fully underwritten before we even go looking for homes? Because when you do that, there's a guarantee loan for you, and all that has to be approved at that point is the home. That takes a lot of risk away from the seller going, oh, this buyer, they're good, and my home is fantastic, so there's not much risk for me in this. Okay, another one is inspections. Can you shorten that time frame? Or maybe the home is in fabulous condition from what you can see when you look at it, and maybe you're willing to buy the home as is, which means you don't ask for any repairs later on. This is another risk reducer for the seller because they know if they accept your offer and you're buying it as is, they know that later on, you're not gonna come back and say, renegotiate with them saying, can you do this, this, and this, or give me this, this, and this. They know what they're getting with you. You are putting your best foot forward. These are just ideas. This is not saying you have to do this on your offer, but if it's right for you, and it's right for this house, maybe consider some of these to make you look more desirable to the seller. If you're thinking about buying a home and you know you're competing and you want someone there beside you that can help guide you through this process, give us a call at the number below. We would be honored to help you. And in the meantime, subscribe to our YouTube channel because every Friday we get a new video out for you. Home buyers, this is, okay, well, I just gotta figure out how to make it go.